panel two. Actually, this isn't panel two. I've got a few panels before this that I did previously. I did some stuff with this character here, and yeah, it I called him Gonna Eatcha. But I don't know, I went off that idea, so I thought I was bringing in a baddie too soon, so I thought of another way of having a fight sequence here. This is this fight sequence goes on for quite a time, and I like it because it goes from a small scrap to something a bit bigger, which is quite nice. If you'd watched I did some Facebook stuff, and I was just drawing it out over there, and anyway, you'll know what happens if you saw that. But I'm just using this for my ink dropper to fill in the gaps that I've got before it goes mentile. And there's a bit of artwork too. Shall I show you that? That I did. It was a bit of concept art, but I think it's here. Oh yeah. This is what they discover. This is the collector. I might add a few bits to that later, actually. Anyway. So, back to this artwork. Oh, hang on a sec, someone at the door. Right, anyway, so I'll get back to this. I'll do a few of these, I should think, actually. I'll bore you to death. And I won't talk too much. But I was having a think about Dark Star. And if you haven't seen it, it's about these sort of space hippies. They're on a deep space mission and they're blowing up planets, and they have these nuclear weapons, these well, they're bombs, and they're capable of blowing up planets. Not really explained why they're doing this, but it's brilliant. It's John Carpenter's first film, and he made it as a student, I think, and there's in his mate's garage. Dan O'Bannon's in it, the guy who wrote, or one of the writers for Alien. He started the whole chest burster stuff. That was sort of the bit in his script that they really, that blew their minds. He didn't have a woman in it, apparently. Anyway, there's a section on that, which is quite prophetic, and basically there's a computer malfunction, and one of the bombs wants to explode. It thinks it needs to explode, and it doesn't, and it won't have it that the information was faulty. So what they try to do is they try to teach it phenomenology, or not basically they try to teach it that the information it was getting was fake news. Literally fake news, that although it can't see, it just gets it information from electronic sort of stimuli, and that electronic stimuli is a figment of its imagination, and actually the order to explode was faulty. And that actually there's nothing exists apart from it. It's the only thing in the universe. So it takes this fake news has a think about it and decides that it's God and explodes. So its line is, let there be light. There is nothing, you know, there's only darkness. Let there be light. Now tell me that doesn't remind you of someone. He probably does think they're a god, to be honest. Anyway, that just made me laugh this morning in a kind of way. Anyway, I'll get on with this. So I'm building this suit up using coloured line work, basically, and cheating wherever I can. If you want to buy the first issue, it's on sale at Etsy. I'm hoping to get an issue on Comixology as well. I'm having my first go. Probably they won't accept the first issue, I don't know. Maybe they will. Anyway, I'm feeling much better today. Yesterday, God, I was going to do a run and I just did not feel like it. But today I've had my little run and I feel a lot better. Apparently there's a Will Smith film coming out on Netflix. I don't know what it's called. I was watching Collider this morning. And they were saying that there's quite a big budget for it, something like 90 million. And it's a world, a sort of parallel world, that fairies and goblins and dwarves exist in parallel, in tandem with ours, you know. So there's not just different races, there are different humanoid beings with magical powers and what have you. And it looks quite interesting, apparently. I think there was a trailer on the Oscars, but yeah, looked pretty good. There we go. Alright, yeah, I want to sort of echo the way her head goes. Let's just, because I'm doing the same attitude. Just bring that over. Oh dear. Right, what do I need to do? I need to flip horizontal, free transform, and keep it the same sort of aspect ratio. That's probably the right sort of size. So I'll use that as my guide. Let's just move around a bit. That's it. And okay. I think it's probably that. There we go. Oh, slurp of coffee. Don't worry if I go quiet. I don't think I could sustain talking forever. Actually, just in case anyone on Twitch wants to say anything to me, I will put it on. By all means, follow me. The more followers I have, the more I'll be able to do it. There we go, we're online, excellent. Okay, I'll just put it on chat. Welcome to the chat room. Okay. Yeah, so that should, is that how you do it? I don't know. Yeah, okay. That, if you need to say anything, go ahead and I will answer it. Hang on a second. That's the wrong colour, isn't it? Oh, pardon me. Oh, there we go. Right. Let me just do that on another layer. Darker. Okay, I'm happy with that. Might just tip the image up, so hang on, I want to go clockwise, don't I? There we go. Just to do this body, and yeah, it's a bit, when I drew it slightly wrong. Here's me dog. Oh God, what's that? Best check this out. I don't think it's anything. Google? Alright. Load of rubbish. Right, okay, get on with it. So, I'll do this torso. And this character, which is Scout actually, has heard something. So I quite like the idea of this character just being asleep while all this is going on. What I'll do is actually I will flip it. Flip vertical. Open right. Anyway. Okay. Yeah, let's just apply it. I'll get rid of that. Oh, itchy ear. My next door neighbour was telling me that he had an ear infection and my ear's gone a bit funny, so hopefully I haven't got it. Oof, could do without that. Right. Saw Graham Norton with, well, I didn't see him, but the TV programme. Patrick Stewart says he's not going to be Professor X anymore. I've got so much time for that man. He's just so good at what he does. Seems to be such a nice human being. And as I said in the past, some of the best acting I've ever seen. Certainly in a TV programme. When he was being tortured by the Cardassians, it's one of the most amazing bits of acting you'll ever see. Right. Yeah, I like that. And, oh God, itchy ear, I'm in trouble. Yeah, it's these capsules here, which is quite pleased that I managed to get this bit in, because I do like this image here, which I'm going to reuse. The memory vials. The memory vials have survived. Oh yeah, let's save this actually, save as. What was it? C2 page 1B. Here's my doggy. If you want to follow me on Facebook, Twitter, it's that. Right. I might cheat, actually. And what have I got? Part one. Oh, no, it's not there, though, is it? There we go. I'll reuse this guy if I can find it. That's it. Okay. I know it's cheating, but, you know, no one's paying me for this as yet. If you want to start following me on Patreon, I'll be able to do it all, you know, above board. But at the moment, my time is money, so. Yeah, that looks nice. Right, so let's put that image back counterclockwise. Okay. Turn that off for now. just saw the latest wisecrack. Actually, they were talking about Suicide Squad and how there was a germ of a interesting script there, but how they feel it's been edited out. Because basically they liked the guys who edited the trailer, so they got them to re-edit the entire film, which is fucking crazy. And so disrespectful to the actual artist who bloody did the film. That's why no one wants to work for them, actually, because they're arseholes. In that respect, they do Harry Potter and everything they understand, but I don't think they understand the DCU. Anyway, Wisecrack. Check it out on YouTube. They are brilliant. Really good. I like Earthling Cinema. Garrix Wormuloid. Absolutely brilliant. That's Patreon. Thanking me for... I do... support other Patreoners, because you know that's only right. If I expect people to support my art, then you know I should support other people's. So that was my little thank you email. I wonder whether to, I know it's a bit much really, but to actually ask people on Facebook directly to become my patron. Because I know there's a lot of people who look at my stuff and enjoy it. And I just think, you know, maybe if you enjoy my work, maybe you should... just, you know, help a little bit. Just support my art, that would be nice. Just makes you feel a little bit worthless when people just take it and wipe their backside on it, and then you're on Facebook and you go, no, you know, if you could support me, that'd be really cool. And it, you know, I do so much. I'd create new stuff and I'd just sort of weep for the stuff that, you know, you're only on this planet for a limited amount of time that I could have possibly done, and just haven't got the time to do it because I have to do other things to keep my head above water. Because, you know, it doesn't just happen in, you know, thin air. I've got to be able to pay for bills and what have you. I saw it talking to someone, they were going on about Greenpeace. Why did they need the money? Because they were all volunteers, and it's like, yeah, but they need to feed the people, you know, petrol for boats and, you know, also mooring, you know, fees. You're not in a... people that do things like that aren't in a bubble. They need money to actually... buy equipment, and that's me, you know. I need, you know, electricity bills and children to feed. Right, yeah. So, just looking at the details. Instantly forgetting the details. There's a sort of little line here. Yeah, I mean, if I had enough Patreon support, I'd just be doing this. But I have to do work for other people in order to keep alive. If I had enough Patreon support, I would be able to do this all the time. Just make comics for you. And answer questions, I think there's a, I think it's £50 a month, and I'd actually do a free, well, not a free lesson, but you know, I'd sit on Skype and do a lesson. How to draw and whatnot. So it's not as if you're paying for nothing, you're paying for my expertise. I'm hoping I'll get a few done today, a few pages, well, not pages, but panels. And what I'm doing actually is I'm not laying it out, I'm just letting the artwork kind of inform me. So hang on a second. What if that artwork show, where will that be? Where will that be? Maybe it's there. Nope. So it's not there. Oh, wait on a second. I think I remember where I put it. It's... oh, gosh. Not there. I put it in its own... oh, preface. Preface. Oh gosh, it's gonna be difficult to find. Shit. Yes, I really laid this out well. That's all right. Oh, it might be stair? No, it's not stair. Ah, oh, there. Yeah. Oh. Oh, I think it's that. Yes. Correct. There's a lesson to be learned there, and I haven't learned it yet. So. Yeah, I'm going to reuse this artwork. Because it's so nice. Oh, it's quite big. What's really nice when I went to Demon Con was there was some young kids there who wanted to be, you know, cartoonists, illustrators, and just giving them advice was lovely. And I could, you know, on Patreon, if you are my patron, I could have dialogue with you. I'd be perfectly happy to do that. Any questions you have? All right, so we have that. Boop. Probably, I'll tell you what, open. No. Open recent. Do that again because I might want to cut into the actual vial and not the glow. So let's get rid of that, make that the same size, yeah, and then. I'll turn that off for now. And I think, shall I do a... I'll do a mask. And the way you do a mask is you... you press that little button there and you see you get this layer thing. And then you use black. I think it's black. Oh, hang on a sec. And black just turns transparent, and it's a black mask. And it's just a good way of keeping the integrity of the artwork. So you can just, if you want to use the whole thing again, you can just remove the mask so you don't destroy any art that you've done, like that. And then I can put the glow on it if I want. I might not need it. Oh, hello, not you. The glow. I'll stop that. Right. There we go. But let's take that off for now. Well, yeah, that looks better because it actually looks like it's in his fingers. Oh my god, oh god. I was doing this yesterday. Let's just move his eyes down a little bit. What was that? Yeah, so. Save. Okay. Oh, pardon me. Right. A bit more detailing on that arm, I think. Again. What I might do is get this one done, have a little break, and then come back and do another panel for you. Just continue doing these until... I've got to have dinner. But I might do another one after dinner as well. So I do about three today. I think this is nice for you to be able to see. It's certainly going to be nice for me to see. If the Robonauts does anything and becomes successful, there'll be a little record of how it was made. Which I think would be terrific. I'll be very happy. Oh dear, it'll become a historic document, or not. It would be nice if it turned into something, but it's all down to you. If you know, I need your support for this. There we go. Give it a trim. I think I'm just gonna on the pencil. I don't think I've done the feet big enough. So what I'm gonna do is get the free transform tool. Oh, that's better. The feet are pretty flappy. There we go. Yeah. I'm happy with that. There we go. Right. Dreamer. Can you put your hands in your head? Oh no. Right. So. I think, yeah, the foot's a bit too long, actually. I'm just snipping away some of the line work. It's a bit clumsy, I think. That's the last thing I need it to be. It'll be fairly slick. But I don't want it too slick. This is, might be work, I doubt it. Let's have a look. Okay, do do do. Okay, that's quite nice. And just felt like something was crawling on me then. Much as I like the summer, you get horrible little crawly things. I do like the summer. I think it's better than winter. Should I do that? I don't know. Tell you one thing I do like about the summer, it's the light and the bird song. Though at 5 o'clock in the morning when the birds wake up, I mean, what's their problem? Are they just shouting, "We're awake, we're awake"? I mean, what's the deal? Maybe they've got a job and they need to, you know, like an alarm, they're waking their mates up. So, anyway. I might be able to, because what I've done is I've designed this in bits. Oh yeah, I think I can. So I can move that down a bit. There we go. That saves me a job. So basically that's her drawn. So what I'll do is I'll put that all in a folder. So now I can move her all over the place, wherever I want. And just do a background. That's sort of sympathetic with this. Gonna lose that thing, that's not gonna be there. No, can I? Yeah, I'm gonna change that dialogue's not gonna be there, it's gonna be different. It's not the harvester unit, it's a collector. It's So yeah, I've changed the language a bit as well. Right, so I think what I'll do, what shall I do? Oh, I'll tell you what, I'll colour her up is what I'll do. Let's get rid of that. How am I going to do that? Well, yeah, if I colour her up, what sort of colour is she? I think it's that. That's not colour. No, I don't know. Hang on a second. Harvester panel, might be that one. Aha! Found it. So yeah, I'll just remove some of the shading. Aha! There we go. Oh god. Sorry, boring myself. So, I think what I did, I used the background. Yeah, well, that's quite smart of me. Okay, well, I might do that then. I might, because it's like a fishbowl, isn't it? So,
yeah. Oh, very clever. Yeah.
Okay. So I'll just airbrush her suit, I think. I'll do a bit of shading on her head. It's nice to go back and see what techniques you used in the past. Oh dear. Now I'm doing the same colour, you doink. I do love a bit of airbrushing. Probably use it too much. But I want these panels to be quite filmy. I don't know if I'm achieving that at all, but and I love what other artists do, don't get me wrong. But what I'm looking for, I can't do it too minimalist, I don't know, and you know, I try, but I just end up putting more and more stuff on. Oh dear. So go to filter gallery and I want the sponge effect, and it'll just make her skin all sort of look a bit translucent and dappled. Where is it? There you go. It's probably not enough, so I'm just going to increase the brush size a bit. A definition. There you go, that's probably alright. There you go. I'll come back to that later. For now, I will. Oh, I know what. There's. No, actually. Yes, hang on. I'm in an argument with myself. No, her head's facing forward, so. This is going to be What's time now? Oh, yeah. I've got enough time to do this, then make dinner. Gonna have sausages and I'll make my own chips with turmeric and paprika on it. Oven chips, lovely. Turmeric's very good for you. Can prevent some forms of cancer, so you should have a bit of it in your food every day. So there. Okay, right. What better way to have it than on chips? Do 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 do. See, the pencil looks more awkward than the actual artwork, which I'm very pleased about. Yeah, I think that adjustment in the feet just made it more grounded, gave it a bit more weight. That's what I'm going to say. Oh dear, right.
Oh, that's my excuse anyway. Oh, God. Ugh. Gonna have to have a biscuit with it. Or banana cake. I made some banana cake today. Oh dear, lovely. I'll make a nice banana cake.
Gonna try and make some lemon meringue over the weekend. With a biscuit base. Ooh. Get those digestives. I haven't had a lemon meringue in ages. So the light is going from this, just going to affect this area. So that's going to be darker there. Might have to put a bit of yellow on it. We'll see. Church bells are ringing. Oh my goodness. It's like having a noisy neighbour. Still, when we went to Turkey, we'd got there really late. It's about 1 o'clock at night or something, and we were sleeping in our beds like you do, and my daughter started screaming, saying there was a lady singing outside her room. This was like 5 o'clock in the morning, like some sort of ghost. And then we're like, no, that's the call to prayer. Oof, gosh. Can I have a lay-in, please? I don't believe in God, so can you shut up? That's nice. So yeah, that's pretty much. Oh yeah, I just gotta put a little bit of red on that there.
Oh yeah, gonna shadow the head up a bit later. Oh gosh,
hang on a sec. Sorry, apologies, apologies. I'll just open what I did yesterday, which is this one. Oh, these are all the bits of artwork I did. Really want to do that one. Anyway, that is that, I think. Cool. That looks good. Bloody hell, yeah. Ooh. Yeah, that looks nice. Yeah, I sort of want to echo that as well. Okay. So, hang on a sec. So there's this one. Yeah, so it's a slight incline. This. Right. And I will just ink drop. Oh, hang on a second. Hang on a second. Right, so I'll use this as the base colour. And let's just go back to here. Maybe I can. Let me just see. Might be able to just drop that in the. Oh, not you. Go away, you. Might be able to. Hang on. Boink. Drop this in the background. It's sort of cheating, but I have done it. It's my work. Okay. Maybe make it a bit bigger. Yes, that's nice. Ooh. Okay, yeah, I like that. And just check my emails. Ooh. Well, that's nice. Someone's asked me for animated football dance celebrations. So that might be some work for me. Lovely. Right. Okay. Let me start. Right, I'm just doing this. You alright?
And can I mix him with Italy?
Well, yeah, but I will be making dinner.
What's for dinner?
Sausages, chips, you know, the nice ones. And I was thinking baked beans,
okay.
And peas.
And do you need lemonade?
Yes. There it is.
There it is.
Right. But yeah, I'd hang off the potato bits if I was you, George.
Yeah.
After I do this, I'll make dinner, okay? That's a great noise. Oh yeah, the floor, hang on a sec, how have I done the floor here though? It's a bit dusty, isn't it? So that's nice, nice little inquiry. That's probably yeah, I'm just trying to think how much I'll charge for that. It's a few hours work per dance. You guys, if you want to keep up with what's going on in cinema and comics and stuff, follow Collider Video. They are amazing. Really good bunch of guys. Really helped me with my Kickstarter. A lot of them, not all of them, but Schnepp, you didn't retweet. Anyway. They don't even know who I am. If you want to keep abreast of all the breaking news in Hollywood, Collider Video, they're fantastic. Big thumbs up. So that's Collider Video, Wisecrack. Is it Wisecrack? It's Wisecrack. Hang on a sec, I'm just going to check. Hang on a second. It is Wisecrack. Cracked is good as well. But hang on, let's just have a look. New rock stars, they're amazing. They do breakdowns of like Legion and The Walking Dead. They're really good. I love those guys. Kevin Smith, of course, yeah, Wisecrack, What Culture are good, and Mr. Sunday, Looper, all right, Nerdwriter, oh my god, he is so good, I love Nerdwriter, yeah, and the Film Theorist, he's great as well, check those guys out, but Collider Video, I watch them all the time, so massive amount of respect for those dudes and ladies, actually. Thing is, though, I do call men and women chaps. Sounds a bit weird when I say it. Chaps are things you have on horses, don't you? Anyway, and some women get offended and they go, well, you know, I'm just, it's fairly generic to me, actually. Get off your high horse. Anyway. Okay, let's have a look with the background in. Yeah, it's not too bad. I think I need this. Yeah. And what I'll do with this, I think I'll stick it on its in its own folder, and then do another version, flatten it, and then expose it. Knock the exposure down. Okay, and then get the rubber and remove elements of it that are being caught by the light. So let's go in a bit closer. This is quite a nice way to make shading. And you get the right sort of colour for the shadows, because basically you've just darkened the colour with exposure, so it should be fairly spot on. Just suggesting there's other sort of rocks and things. Three-dimensional. You know what? I think even if Mel Gibson produces the best damn films in the world, I'll never go and see his films, purely because he is sexist and racist. I really don't like his politics, so I don't care if he makes the best damn films ever. I can't forgive him. I'd happily watch his video films as a pirate, you know, but I hate people who watch films that are pirated. I think that's awful. I've done it myself, unfortunately, but if I do like the film, I will buy it. I haven't done it that often. But yeah. God, it's hard to be completely pure in this world, isn't it? That's why I like Spotify. It's a great way. You know, obviously you pay £9.99 a month, but you get most of the new sort of music and what have you. I used that for my birthday party, it's fantastic. Great way to work out what sort of party music you want. You can just surf and, you know, all the sort of music's there. There are a few annoying ones that aren't. I don't think Prince was there at that time. It is now. Oh, that's looking nice. So yeah, where that is, I think I'll do just a sort of lighter bit, and then maybe where she is, a shadow. Oh well, that's a bit big though.
Oh, bit big.
So. Okay, so what did I say? I said I was going to, for the helmet, I was going to use the background. Oh, hang on a sec. If I do that, just, oh, maybe, hang on a sec. Maybe do another version and knock that down even more in exposure. Hang on a sec. Make it darker. And then hang on. Okay. Yeah, that looks nice. All right. So. I'll put that in its own group. It's probably my daughter. That's my wife. Okay. Right. So. Yeah, so I've put all the background on that level there, and I'm going to make a copy of it, and that bit, let's just get rid of that for a second. So I've made a circular bit, and I'm going to then distort, spherize. This takes a few seconds to work itself out. And I'll go, yes, so I go boom. So it spherizes it. And then I will, hang on a sec, and oops.
We all know.
That needs to be knocked back a bit, so I think what I'll do is I'll just image, I'll expose it. Let's just, if I do that, maybe it needs to just be blurred a bit. Oh yeah, that's nice. Okay. So if we see that in situ, that's good. All right. So she looks a bit bright now. Okay, so she looks a bit bright, so what I'll do is I'll do another copy. Oh, hang on a second. Oh, damn. Just turn that off for a second. Turn that off for a second. Yeah, there we go. Another copy, then flatten it. And turn that back on. Maybe that needs to go on top of that, actually. Alright, so I've got two copies. I'm going to image, I'm going to do the exposure on this. So just knock the exposure down a bit and up on this. and it's just the light from the background, from the actual sort of cave, and this light source here. I'm going to use the rubber on this. Just pick out little bits on the face and what have you that will be affected by the light. And I think also what I'll do is just go over it and put in a bit of white highlighting as well. I want it to be nice and atmospheric. And I might just touch it up with a bit of yellow, very slight. You know, because it's sort of like an ambient light source. Does that make sense? Yeah, but that's looking far more like it's part of this scene. I love light, I really do. So, for this, I think I'll just add a little bit of yellow. And just sort of bouncing off the suit. Sort of radiating. Right. I think I might just do a little bit of white, tight white, just there. There we go. Yeah, there's our first little panel. Right, I'm going to start making dinner because my son will start eating everything in the fridge. And we can't have that. So I will speak to you later. I'll do another one after dinner. Lovely. See you soon.